Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway by Susan Jeffers. It is about that we all have fears and how to conquer them effectively. Today we often can get by, so to speak, without facing anything. But if we want to grow in our external and in our internal world, we have to face fear. Susan Jeffers describes that fear has three levels. The level one fear is the external thing. You think you are afraid of it. It can be passive, like dying, being alone or rape, or active, like public speaking, asking your boss for a raise, approaching a potential mate. We feel uncomfortable and try to avoid it. Then there is a level 2 fear. It is the fear of the internal feeling you get from imagining not succeeding. This can be helplessness, disapproval, rejection by friends or family, or to be cheated on by a partner. And finally, there is a level 3 fear. She calls it the real fear. And the fear is that you think, I can't handle it. What really means, I can't handle what happens after I don't succeed. She says that it is really the core of every fear. But most people never get to it because they shut down at level 1 or 2. You can easily see that it is the underlying fear of everything if you turn it around and ask yourself, what do I have to fear if I can handle anything? And the answer is nothing. So to diminish fear, you have to develop trust in your own capabilities. So she recommends that saying I'll handle it gets to the core of every fear, and that saying I'll handle it diminishes the fear over time. Another great part of the book is the chapter where she writes about the 5 truths of fear. The first one is everyone feels fear, and everyone tries to hide it, so it's easy to think that others don't feel fear. The second one is that facing the fear is the only way to make it go away. You first have to face it, and then your comfort zone will expand. Not the other way around. And then you will become an improved version of yourself, and the fear will be gone. The third truth is that the good feeling comes after doing it. After doing it, the fear will be gone. And you get a bonus of feeling exceptional and more powerful. Some people even start to cry because of the feeling of relief. Truth number 4 is, you will feel fear on unfamiliar territory. And so does everybody else who enters new territory. Facing the fear will expand your comfort zone and adds a new territory to your old comfort zone. And the last one is, pushing through fear is a less frightening option. Think about it. Living our life with fear and the feeling of helplessness is way worse than pushing through it one time. There is also a great practical exercise that Susan Jeffers recommends in the book. She calls it the pain to power continuum. Fancy name. The continuum reaches from 0 to 100. 0 stands for your ultimate fear, and 100 stands for the feeling of total confidence. Now you can pick any area of your life. Approaching a potential mate, asking your boss for a raise, starting a new career, or making an important phone call you're avoiding. At first, you should ask yourself, where am I on the continuum? So I'm afraid of spiders, and I'm at 30 on the continuum. And second, you should ask yourself, what is the next step to move from 30 to, let's say, 35? So I'm already fine with watching spiders on YouTube, but I'm afraid of real ones. So the next step for me is to face my fear and watch a real spider in a glass until I'm totally fine with it and feeling completely confident and calm in front of a real spider. She suggests to do this for every challenge you fear, and slowly moving from fear to total confidence.